What's up, you guys? Welcome to another vlog. Today's kind of different. It's more of a tribute vlog to my dog that we had to put down. She had cancer, so we had to put her down a couple days ago. I felt like she's really shy, so not that many of my, only like three or four of my friends have ever met her. She usually hid under the bed or something. So here's a tribute video to her and kind of her story. So we got Ella when I was all the way back in elementary school. I think I was in fourth or fifth grade, so I was fairly young. We drove all the way to Kentucky to get her. We went to Louisville, Kentucky, which is about 3 hours from where I live in Indianapolis. And she was super timid, and the Humane Society that we got her from was like, "Are you sure you want Polly?" which was her name, because like she was terrified of everything, and they found her on the street, and most likely they're just going to put her down if nobody picked her up. So my mom had to have this dog. She wanted a German Shepherd. She was a German Shepherd mutt. Nobody knew what she was because she was found on the street. And when we found her, we had to get her. I mean, she was really, really sweet, but really scared. We brought her home. She was super scared. We had other dachshunds, little wiener dogs, which are very mean dogs typically. So they did not get along at all for a while. Ella would just hide under stuff or hide in little corners in the house for a long time. After a while, she got really close and, you know, fit in perfectly. But when I was in sixth grade, my school district works different than the school district that my mom and stepdad work for. So I was already on summer break and they were still working. So I was playing Xbox and I was like, you know what? I'm gonna let the dogs outside. So I let the dogs outside. Then I went back inside my room to play some more Xbox and kind of forgot about the dogs were outside. We have a fenced in yard. It's like a 7-foot fence, so very tall. And I went back outside and Ella was gone. Had no idea where she was. I got on my bike, rode around the neighborhood, went across the street to the big neighborhood across the street from me. Still couldn't find her. We posted stuff on social media, asked people to call around and look for her, and we couldn't find her. So 3 years go by, and the Hamilton County Humane Society, which I live in Marion County, which is in Indianapolis. Hamilton County is like Carmel, Zionsville, all of them. They called us and told us that they found our dog. This is 3 years later, and they found her 6 miles away. So here's the news clips from it when the news came to our house to talk to us. And then also a clip from the Hamilton County Humane Society when we were featured as a family there since they found our dog, so.
I wanted a German Shepherd so bad, and he wasn't going for that. But I was looking on just like Pet Finder, and I saw this picture of her. I just decided I had to have her. I mean, she was just so timid and so sweet. The very first memory I have of her is walking in the house in our laundry room. Our house is kind of like in a circle, and our laundry room is right here, and our washer and dryer, we had like a space between. The first thing she did was run up and get in between those two to hide. Well, he was home. He was in middle school, and he called me, and he's like, "Mom, I don't know what to do. I can't find Ella." And she, like we said before, she's a master hider. I mean, she would find anywhere to hide.
So the first thing we did when we got home was grab the other dogs and take them for a walk like we always did, thinking she hears them, she's going to come up. And when she didn't, that's when, you know, the fear kind of set in of, uh-oh, she's gone.
Ella's whereabouts for the last 3 years were a mystery to her family. But for nearly the last 2.5 years, employees of Butler Toyota, nearly 6 miles away from Ella's home, were trying to take care of this timid and supposedly stray dog.
All right, yeah, I just want to emphasize how, like, insane that is. I mean, 6 miles is extremely long. Like, the image here, this says it would take me an hour and 53 minutes to walk over there. Note, there is always construction going on. There was construction going on there 6 years ago when this happened. However many years ago when this happened. So, I mean, just the idea that, like, surviving that long of a distance is just really crazy. We just always like to think that she had a crazy life. I'm gonna let the video finish too, but just to show you, like, how far that actually is. And you have to go over 465 Meridian Street, 86th Street, Westfield Boulevard, and you gotta go through Keystone, which is just a mess. So
Butler Toyota and the employees there had been feeding this dog that was living in the woods next to their dealership for about 3 years. They found out that the woods was going to be developed, so they decided that they needed some help getting this dog trapped and taken to safety. The Indianapolis Humane Society was not able to help, so they passed along the information to us.
I just want to touch, the reason this video was made was so the Hamilton County Humane Society can make money, but the Hamilton County Humane Society is only only shelter in Indiana that is not a kill shelter, so they don't put down any of their animals unless it's like dead. So a lot of times, so in Indianapolis or the Marion County Humane Society, if Ella was found there and nobody found her or nobody took her or whatever, it should be put down because of it. But in Hamilton County, they don't do that. That's why they're more popular, and they seem to get a lot of more funding from the state. So,
and our animal care manager at the Humane Society for Hamilton County reached out to a couple of the dog walker volunteers to see if we'd be able to help capture the dog.
Ella spent two winters around the dealership.
Definitely like a mascot.
And was taken care of pretty well.
I have a friend who volunteered at the Humane Society with that had some experience with this, Leslie. I reached out to her and she let me borrow a trap that she had used. We actually had a camera on the trap, so we were able to know the second that she went in and was captured. So we were able to get there. My husband and I went at about 9:30 on a Friday night to pick her up. She was really scared, but you could tell that she had somebody that loved her. She was very interested in what we were doing and not nearly as fearful.
With help from the Humane Society and the Friends of Indianapolis Dogs Outside, Ella was finally captured Friday.
It was late at this point, but we had to know if she was microchipped to see if there was somebody out there looking for it. Just couldn't wait till the morning, so we went and got the scanner, and I really wish I could have seen my face when I held it up to her and it beeped and the number came across.
It didn't take long to reunite her with her family. She's been microchipped for several years.
Match the owners to the dog that quickly, that's amazing.
It's just so hard to believe. 3 years is a long time.
Ella reunited with her family Saturday morning at the Humane Society for Hamilton County in Noblesville. 3 years ago, Ella's family had two other dogs. Now she has three other furry companions to help welcome her back home. On Indy's North Side, Randy Spieth, Fox 59 News.
You guys do everything for animals. I mean, we're animal lovers, obviously, four dogs. You know, we appreciate everything that you guys have done. And yeah, the fact that, you know, you crossed over to Marion County, we never in a million years would have dreamed that Ella would come back home. And the fact that she's here today is for you guys.
That's my girl.
But yeah, as I was saying, unfortunately we had to put her down. She was pretty sick. She just was not acting normal. Normally she stays under the bed, but instead she would like go to random parts of the house and just lay down. All her dogs pretty much go to the same place, their own little place, but she would like go to weird places and just lay down. So we took her to the vet, and the vet didn't think that she was gonna make it a few more days, so we did put her down. It's just kind of a tribute to her and a thank you to the Humane Society of Hamilton County. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. Here's some pictures of her that I took. She's by far one of the most photogenic dogs I've ever seen for how shy she is. And I know I just posted a video of her a couple weeks ago. Yeah, so that's pretty much it. Thanks again for watching. Enjoy the little pictures of the dogs. I want you out of my bedroom tonight. There's no way I can save you, 'cause I need to be set to. I'm no good at goodbyes. Made for my mom and stepdad. My stepdad doesn't have any kids, obviously. And you know, my mom, whatever, I'm the baby, but either way, dogs are kind of like our kids and like our family, like, you know, close to us. So I made this for them with all our dogs and stuff. by far my favorite pictures of Lucy ever. With a little toy in her mouth. But yeah, so I made this for them. Kind of a tribute. As Ella. And then some of the pictures that I just showed her on there too. But yeah, thanks again for watching.